There is an absolute fortune to be made with pre-foreclosures. I'm here with the master, Pace Morby. He's gonna break down the 8 options that you have with every single pre-foreclosure.
Check this out.
Hey guys, it is Brent Daniels, and if you are getting value out of these videos, make sure that you like and subscribe. So let's get into this. We're talking about pre-foreclosures, and now more than ever, these deals are popping up and they are turning into massive deals, not only from a wholesale perspective, but also from a buy and hold perspective.
Absolutely, creative finance is money when it comes to pre-foreclosures.
Now, a lot of people, this is what is incredible, and the reason why I'm making this video and bringing this up is because I think everybody in every market is leaving so much money on the table because they're not taking pre-foreclosures seriously, the ones that don't have equity. And we'll get into that.
Absolutely.
But there are 8 options that Pace is gonna break down, and I'm gonna ask the questions. I'm gonna make sure that we're crystal clear on every single one of these options so that you can be confident going into any appointment with pre-foreclosures and be able to get the contract signed. So Pace, let's start here. So pre-foreclosures, what is a pre-foreclosure?
Pre-foreclosure means that somebody has fallen behind on their payments.
Yep.
They've been
what given payments?
Their mortgage payments.
The mortgage.
They're behind on their mortgage payments, and they are in a situation where they have been notified that their house is going to be put up for foreclosure, which means they're going to lose their house. They've got some pretty big amount of pain, right?
Yeah. Well, not only that, the interesting thing about pre-foreclosures is there is a very, very specific timeline, right? If you are not making your payments to the bank, they will foreclose. They'll take that property back. They'll kick you out of the house. It is their property now. And there is a date that they will take that to auction.
Absolutely.
So what happens is, in my experience, is in Phoenix here, when you get a notice of default, you get a 90-day window to either make up those payments and get good with the bank again, or they're gonna foreclose.
Knock, 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 the sheriff is coming for the house.
Right.
That's absolutely true.
Right, but the interesting thing is, most people don't start taking action until it's at the last moment possible.
It is crazy. I feel like there's 2 camps. What are those 2 camps? I feel like you and I kind of have the same belief in that.
Yep, there's people that have equity, and there's people that don't have any equity in their house.
Right, so in those 2 camps, it really doesn't matter. It is very interesting. People don't start taking action until about the halfway mark. It gets scary really, really fast. So the 8 options, which we're gonna go over today, are money. They are game changing. Most people are just calling pre-foreclosures and saying, I wanna give you a cash offer. Guys, you're leaving so many opportunities on the table, and you're also getting a lot of doors and a lot of text messages and cold calls going unanswered because you're not using the right methodology. So let's get into it.
Yeah, let's go. Option number one.
Option number one, guys. Sometimes we had a seller one time where the husband had passed away, the wife hadn't been in the workforce for 10 years. And so really what she just needed was a personal loan. And so what we helped her do is gain the courage to go to a family member and get a personal loan for 2 or 3 months so she could get caught up on her payments. The right thing to do was to help that seller out in that situation to get the courage to stay in that house. This isn't always about buying the house. It is always about helping the seller. I can tell you that right now. And asking somebody about the personal loan situation will get you customer facing, where no longer will they have a guard and stop blocking your texts, stop blocking your cold calls, because you've gone after truly helping them by giving the confidence that they needed to go get a personal loan.
So are you saying, because we talked about this off camera and I thought this is brilliant, everybody in the room thought this is brilliant, that you go instead of, hey, are you in foreclosure? Do you want to sell your house? You ask them, do you need a personal loan to help you out with this situation?
Right.
That's brilliant. I mean,
it is money. So here's the thing, guys. We have a team of door knockers. We do SMS and we do cold calling. Our conversion rate skyrocketed when we started saying we're going to be customer facing. And the first line we say to a seller, we say we have 8 ways to help you. Actually, we tell them we have 7 ways to help you keep your house. And they immediately go, oh my gosh, this guy's not trying to attack me. He's not coming after me and trying to take my equity. He's actually wanting to help me. And we start by going and helping them get a personal loan if that is indeed what they need. And immediately you start getting all the things about the story, all the situation, the backstory of why they're in the situation they're in. And now you can start solving problems that no other competition is going to be able to do. because they don't have the right information.
What's the percentage of people that actually get personal loans? Because here, these are people in financial distress. These are people that can't afford their mortgage as it is, let alone a high interest payment from a family, or maybe the family member's not charging them
interest. The percentage, honestly, is very, very low. It's less than 1% of the people we talk to. It's probably 1% of 1%, to be honest.
But it's a way to get in the
door. It's a conversation starter. It's an icebreaker, and it's also telling them, we are here to help you. We're not here to take advantage of you. If that is the best option, we're gonna help you get that option done.
I am telling you, if you go in with the end game in mind to help this seller out, most of the time, truly, their best option for them is to get out of the property.
With all the questions I get personally, DMs or otherwise, the number one question we get is, how are your door knockers, how are your SMSs getting through to the seller, whereas your competition is not? And guys, that is number one, going at them with that approach of, can we help you around the personal loan side?
All right, number two.
Agent. So guys, again, if they have an agent that they're talking to, you wanna pull that to the forefront. You wanna find out if they have a brother, a cousin, a sister, whatever, that is an agent that is going to be your competition on the other side. Otherwise, if you don't bring that out and you're starting talking about cash offers, which is what everybody's doing, they start ghosting you, they start doing whatever, and you don't know why. But if you bring this to the forefront and you say, look, why haven't you listed your property? Yep. They're gonna tell you so many more things about why they haven't listed the property. I don't have time. That's good info. Mm-hmm. I have a job opportunity. I have to leave. I need these things, that, whatever. Or I don't have an agent. Mm-hmm. What if somebody doesn't have an agent? What do you do?
Refer them an agent.
Refer them an agent.
Refer them an agent. Yeah.
Right. So those
but
are good things.
But most of the time, here's the thing, guys. Most of the time, people don't want to list their property a lot of times because they're embarrassed.
100%.
They're embarrassed because this is a pre-foreclosure. They're embarrassed maybe in the condition of the property. They're embarrassed by, you know, if somebody comes into their house and their dog bites them or something. A lot of people don't want to list. And a lot of people don't really trust real estate agents that have their best interests in mind.
100%. Especially with the timeline looming, the 90 days is getting closer and closer. Yep. They're fearful of it. And so it's nice to just bring that fear to the forefront, have a conversation about it so you can step forward and get closer to helping them with a different method.
Love it. Number three.
Loan modification. Guys, this is something that happens so many times where we would talk to the seller, we get this close to getting a contract, and all of a sudden the seller would ghost us.
Yep.
And then a month later, we touch base with them and find out they were no longer in foreclosure. It's because they were working on a loan mod the entire time we were talking to them.
A loan mod means loan modification. Basically, what the bank does is they take what you owe, they put it on the back side of the loan, they reduce your payments, but you still, the amount that you're not paying them now, they tack onto the back of the loan. It's a win-win for the bank if they feel like the people can actually afford to be able to do that and go through the process. But it is a delicate process. I mean, you got to put a lot of paperwork together, and a lot of these people that are in pre-foreclosure, they don't necessarily follow through with that.
So here's the funny thing is, on my Instagram, I post when I get certain contracts, and I'll say, just got a contract, and I'll have a picture of the house in the background.
What's your Instagram?
My Instagram is Pace Morby on Instagram, guys. Follow me. So one of the other wholesalers in town goes, oh my gosh, I've been working with that seller for 3 months. How'd you get that contract? And I said, because I was talking to them through the whole process of their loan mod, checking in on them. How's it going with the loan mod? How's it going with the loan mod? And never once did I bring up a cash offer or anything else. Yep. I was there as moral support. Mm-hmm. I basically created an ecosystem where me and that seller worked through this loan mod. Mm-hmm. They got rejected on the loan mod. They called who first?
You.
Us.
Yep.
You guys gotta get customer facing, seller facing, and get in their trust zone.
And you get into their trust zone by providing all the options for them to stay in the house or to sell it and get out cleanly before the foreclosure happens. Right. So the whole idea on these steps here is to go through as much effort as possible to provide as much value to them as possible so that they can get out cleanly, so that if all these things don't happen, all of a sudden you're down here in 5 and 4. But let's not skip ahead. Let's go to the rental. Rental.
Rental. I've actually never had a seller one time do a rental.
Right.
But I always bring it up as an option. And the reason being is because I want to make sure that the seller knows all their options, one. And two, I want to tell them why a rental is not a good idea. So essentially, we go to them and go, well, if you're behind on your mortgage, why not just get a renter in here and cash flow a little bit, catch up your mortgage or whatever. And they go, oh my gosh, I don't want to deal with a renter. I'm so stressed out as it is. So that is a good sign that they're in enough pain that you can come in and solve their problem with a cash offer or maybe a creative financing solution.
Love it. Cash offer.
Cash offer. We
this
know where
is
that
is. This is the most typical. This is what most people go at right off the bat. Give them a cash offer if they have equity.
Right.
If there's enough in there, let's get the cash offer. Let's get it locked up. Let's assign that deal. Let's wholesale. This is traditional.
Yes.
This is traditional wholesaling that we talk about a lot on this channel. This is a bread and butter, how you make the biggest spreads.
Right.
From a income standpoint, right?
So what's crazy about this is most wholesalers or real estate investors start here. We, by the time I'm here, which takes about 30 to 45 minutes to get to this point, I've built rapport. I know their dog's name. I know their daughter's favorite color. I know everything about their family and why they're in the situation they're in. So by the time I even go to the cash offer, we're already friends.
Yep.
But you guys, as non-educated up until this video,
right,
go to them immediately as a cash offer. Hey, I'm a cash investor. Guys, they need help. They need moral support. And getting a call from a cash investor isn't gonna warm them up.
Mm-mm.
Start here, and by the time you get to here, you're already in the game.
This is everything.
Yes.
Guys, this is everything. If you're going after pre-foreclosures, this is absolutely the blueprint. I am telling you, nobody does more of these than Pace. Nobody does more of these than Pace. He's doing 2-3 a week. Guys, listen to what he's saying. This is critical. Number six.
So number six, let's say that you go to the cash offer and you talk to the seller and they say, you know, I would love to actually sell. I just need to get rid of this house. I don't have any equity. In fact, if I took the offer you just gave me, I'd have to write you a check for 50 grand. And if I had 50 grand, I'd just catch up my mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do is we then go at them with a subject to creative finance type of model to get in the house and still cash flow for long-term wealth by solving the seller's problem and buying a house that nobody else would have been able to
buy. This is where everybody falls off.
Right.
This is where everybody that's looking for this cash offer that's wholesaling falls off right here. And there is so much to be made.
It is crazy. We just had a meetup. You were our guest speaker, our headliner. And what happened is we had a couple of guys in that group that had been wholesaling for a year. And after we opened up their eyes and talked about these creative options, they immediately went back to their phone book and they got 15 sellers that they turned away last year. And we called those sellers together and we got 3 contracts from sellers that they said, not a deal, trash.
No equity. Because what happens is typically you look at a property, you see if it has equity. If it is, great. Follow up. If it doesn't, gone.
Right.
You're saying I want all those and yes, I'm going to convert those into a subject to or creative financing. Number seven.
Nobody ever has taken me up on this.
Mm-hmm.
However, they go, are those my only options?
Mm-hmm.
And I go, well, I, as a home flipper, I can help you renovate the house and list it and we can split the profits.
Mm.
And they go, oh my gosh, there's not enough time for that. So all of these guys, if they didn't take you up on these offers, we come back in with another one that actually would help them, but they still won't take it. And they go, man, I guess I really don't have any other options besides 5 and 6.
Mm-hmm. And these, equity and no equity. This
right,
could be both.
Right.
But this, you obviously need equity in. But equity, no equity, these are the options. You're pulling through the filters of all these to get to this. Obviously, 8 is bankruptcy, and we don't do bankruptcy. You're not an attorney.
I'm not an attorney, but we will refer them to an attorney. Sure. If that's ultimately the way they need to go, is we'll refer them to an attorney. And through bankruptcy, they can stay in their house for a longer period of time. And I'd say less than 5% of people ever go, maybe even less than 2% of people ever go that route. It's usually, guys, right here. 90% of the contracts that we get are right here. Every once in a while, we'll get an agent that we refer a deal to.
Yep. Guys, listen, there are no secrets. There's just things that you don't know yet. Now you know.
Ooh, I like that.
Now you know. Here is the blueprint. Here is the plan. Go through these 4 things. Knock those all off of their mental checklist so that they don't come back later or that they don't push back. Stiff arm you to make a decision because they think that there's other options out there. Lay out these 8 options. Put it on a piece of paper. Put it in a presentation and bring it to them and say, which one of these looks like something that you'd be interested in? And see what happens. Start the conversation because from there, you're going to get the people that are really going to be willing to work with you. And that's how you make an impact in your community. These are the people that are under the most distress possible. And you can absolutely help them out, but you got to listen to Pace and go through the 8 steps here and really implement it. Don't just see this as education. This is pure instruction.
You have to talk to people, guys.
That's
you
right.
You have to do it.
TTP, guys. So that is it. Pace, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
We're going to do more and more. Please comment down below if you want to see more of me and Pace breaking down different things in his business and different things about Subject 2. Just write down below Subject 2 if you are interested in that. If you're interested in joining the most proactive group in real estate investing, it is the TTP program.
TTP.
Go to wholesalinginc.com/TTP. Scroll down. Check out all the testimonials. Check out what the program is about. If it feels good in your gut, sign up for a call. I look forward to working with you personally. Until next time.